små. Section 178, subsection 3 of the Motor Vehicles Act, any three-wheeled vehicle refusing me a ride to any location is a punishable offence. But guess what? A startup in a tier 2 city came with a solution to this problem. Telerickshaw. Telerickshaw is your auto aggregator that enables you to book your three-wheeled ride on an app. I spoke with the CEO of this startup to get you more details. So what was the motive behind Telerickshaw here? There are multiple transport aggregators out there, but you chose to focus on auto rickshaws. Now, that's a transport sector that's both unorganized and fragmented. So what made you be an auto aggregator?
What I believe is the if you talk about the major rides in a city, is most with the rickshaws. If you talk about any of the rides through public transport, rickshaws are a major volume which takes you across the city and which helps in commutation. Organizing this sector is far more important than any other mode of transport. This is where when I talk to the drivers, they are themselves not aware how many customers they serve a day, how much they earn, monthly income they save, and the expenditure they incur on per kilometer, they're not aware about anything. So this is where I feel like if we start tracking their expenditure, tracking their rides, tracking their daily income, and tracking how much they can serve and the duration they spend on the roads, and the duration on that duration, how much they serve the customers, is what we want to make them assure. And this is where the idea was born, like make them feel responsible that what best they can do in that span of time if they're on roads.
So in your journey towards onboarding 6,500 rickshaw drivers in 12 cities all on your app, did you face any challenges or hesitances from these local drivers in terms of conveying your idea, your vision and the technology behind this app?
To be very honest, technology was not a big constraint. The biggest constraint which we had in this sector was to actually bring them on board, to bring them under our umbrella, because they were very resistive to being tracked, to being monitored, and this is where the biggest barrier was.
So correct me if I'm wrong, Karanveer, when you first started, you had the option of choosing investor funding, but instead of that, you went with the PPP model. You went with government support. What was the reason behind that, and what have been the benefits of the same?
I think Telerickshaw is itself a case study in this domain, in this topic, and it's not just Telerickshaw, I would say it's a domain where everyone should focus, the domain of public-private partnerships. It's just because today's government is very aggressive about bringing a change, and this is an era of evolution wherein we actually need to sync with the mission of government.